As I stand at the lichened gate, with warring worlds on either hand, to left the black and budless trees, the empty sties, the barns that stand, like tumbling skeletons, and to right the factory towers, white and clear, like distant glittering cities seen from a ship's rail, as I stand here, I feel, and with a sharper pang, my mortal sickness, how I give my heart to weak and stuffless ghosts, and with the living cannot live. The acid smoke has soured the fields, and browned the few and wind-worn flowers, but there, where steel and concrete soar in dizzy geometric towers, there, where the tapering cranes sweep round, and great wheels turn, and trains roar by, like strong, low-headed brutes of steel, there is my world, my home, yet why? So alien still, for I can neither dwell in that world nor turn again to scythe and spade, but only loiter among the trees the smoke has slain. Yet when the trees were young, men still could choose their path, the winged soul, not cursed with double doubts, could fly, arrow-like, to a foreseen goal. And they who planned those soaring towers, they too have set their spirit free. To them their glittering world can bring faith and accepted destiny. But none to me, as I stand here, between two countries, both ways torn, and moveless still, like Buridan's donkey, between the water and the corn.